Dear friends, welcome to this fourth video to know what the Venetian merchant Marco Polo has told about Tamil land of 13th century. English translation of old French language Marco Polo travel notes by Henry Yule consists of various details of Tamil land in chapters 16 and 17. Among those notes, today we will see what he had told about Tamils' pearl fishing methods in the land of Tamil Nadu. At this end of the province reigns one of those five royal brothers who is a crowned king, and his name is Sounder Pandi Thevar. In his kingdom, they find very fine and great pearls, and I will tell you how they are got. You must know that the sea here forms a gulf between the island of Ceylon and the mainland. And all around this gulf, the water has a depth of no more than 10 or 12 fathoms, and in some places, no more than 2 fathoms. The pearl fishers take their vessels, great and small, and proceed into this gulf, where they stop for the beginning of April till the middle of May. They go first to the place called Betelar and then go 60 miles into the gulf. Here, they cast anchor and shift from their large vessels into small boats. You must know that the many merchants who go divide into various companies, and each of these must engage a number of men on wages, hiring them for April and half of May. Of all the produce, they have first to pay the king as his royalty the 10th part. And they must also pay those men who charm the great fishes to prevent them from injuring the divers whilst engaged in seeking pearls underwater. 1/20th part of all that they take. These fish charmers are tame, a Brahman, and their charm holds good for that day only. For at night, they dissolve the charm so that the fishes can work mischief at their will. These Abrahmen also know how to charm beasts and birds and every living thing. When the men have got into the small boats, they jump into the water and dive to the bottom, which may be at a depth of from 4 to 12 fathoms, and there they remain as long as they are able. And there they find the shells that contain the pearls, and these they put into a net bag tied round the waist and mount up to the surface with them and then dive anew. When they cannot hold their breath any longer, they come up again, and after a little down, they go once more, and so they go on all day. The shells are in fashion like oysters or sea hoods. And in these shells are found pearls, great and small, of every kind, stitching in the flesh of the shellfish. As soon as the middle of May is past, no more of these pearl shells are found there. It is true, however, that a long way from that spot, some 300 miles distant, they are also found. But that is in September, in the first half of October. In this manner, pearls are fished in great quantities, for thence, in fact, come the pearls which are spread all over the world. We will meet again with another note of Marco Polo about 13th century Tamil land. Until then, thank you for the support.